the losses in shielding and grounding of the bridge, the losses occurring because of inductors and capacitors can be reduced by using of the shielding and grounding of the bridges. The various bridges discussed consist of lumped impedances which do not interact with any way. Some disturbances are going to be occurring because of the impedance, because the resistance is connected in series with the inductance or else in series with the capacitance. And one more thing, the resistance is connected in parallel or in series with the inductance, because there are some losses are going to occur due to the inductance and capacitance. If I am going to use the capacitance, there might be a chances of your capacitors are not in a standard form, or else some damages may occur due to thermal effect. Okay, these are some factors will come across when I'm going to use of your inductor, resistance and capacitance. Okay, how to overcome those? Okay, here a small, in practice, the stray capacitance between various bridges, elements and ground, and between bridges arms themselves exist. The stray capacitance, when I'm going to use of the transistors like inverters and all, even though transistor is having small, which operation is going for? If I provide a zero, it will be getting as a output as one, right? What is the construction is there? Along with that construction, some stray capacitance will come across there. In the circuit, it will not be there. We are not mentioning capacitor is there, but unknowingly, a stray capacitance will be existing in any of the bridges. These stray capacitance shunt the bridge arms and cause considerable error. The stray capacitance are going to be giving a considerable error in the bridge. Okay. The stray capacitance are uncertain in magnitude. The value what you are getting, it's not in a constant. It's like a noise for you, for the your circuit. Okay. They often vary with the adjustment of bridge arms and position of the operator. The stray capacitance, what it is existing, we can avoid by using, just by adjusting the bridge arms. Bridge arms means just by changing the values for your resistance, capacitance and inductance values. Okay. And the position of the operator, somewhat we will fix for some for distance and all like that. Okay. Next. The shielding and grounding of the bridge is one way of reducing the effect of stray capacitance. By using of the shielding and grounding bridge, we can avoid the effect of stray capacitance. Here, who gave the name, how it is going to be done? It's by one person, that is Wagner, gave the concept how to eliminate the stray capacitance. Here it is taken, that is one very effective and popular method of eliminating the stray capacitance and capacitance between bridge arms is using ground connection called Wagner ground connection. This will be important for 6 marks. They may ask, explain about shielding and grounding of the bridge, or else explain about Wagner ground connection. Like two types of question, the same answer is same. How it is done? Just go for this construction. Okay. In the construction, there is a bridge is there. Okay. Across AC, R1 is connected. Across CB, R2 is connected. Across BD, our CX and RX is connected. Across AD, C3, R3 is connected. Along with this, the bridge connection. And across your AB, a headphone is connected, that is this headphone. Okay, along with this, the stray capacitance are C1 and C2. Stray capacitance are C1 and C2. Okay, in this connection, along with this bridge connection, here RW, a variable resistance RW, Wagner resistance and Wagner capacitance is connected, that is CW is connected across the supply. Okay, here The same thing, connection you have to write here. And across CD, we connected the RW and CW. And this is working as a, observe here, it's forming a potential divider. The connection what we done, it's acting as a potential divider, and the arm is called as a guarding arm. Observe, G-U-A-R-D-I-N-G, guarding arm. It's protecting the our bridge. How it is going to work? Observe here, the switch. Yes, we call it is in series with the headphone connection. Okay, first the switch S is connected at the initial position across first position. When across first position is connected, our switch, we are the R1. We are going to vary the R1, and along with varying the R1, we will be listening the what is the sound is going to affecting. What is the sound? It's going to listening in the headphone. This is our headphone, right? For that reason. What is the sound? If the sound is less, then it's okay. When sound is more, we are adjusting our R1. Until a sound is going to be a less listening. When it is less listening, then I will take off the switch and I will connect towards position 2. I will erase the previous one. This is the first one. Okay. Then I will connect across switch across position 2. When I connected switch across position 2, by using of the resistance RW, this resistance, this path, by using the RW variable, this is a variable, the arrow indicating it's of a variable, okay. RW is adjusting such that the sound listening from the headphones, it will be less. When I listening the sound less, after some interval, when it is the sound what is going to be heard from the headphones, when it is less, then I will check that, and then again what I will do, again switching back to the position 1. What I will do? Again switching back to the position 1. 2 is finished, again switching back to position 1. Again some imbalance will occur because I connected across RW. I adjusted. When adjusting, again here the bridge is going to be imbalanced. Again, when I connected to switch at position 1, again I will change the R1 until again a small sound it should occur at the headphone. Like this process is going to be adjusted by using of the switch at position 1 and also at position 2 until I get a null indication in the headphones. Means I should not listen any sound effect there, or else a small sound it should come. Okay, then I will call the bridge is in a balanced, and the capacitance what it is going to exist, it's going to be shunted and it's going to be nullified. C1 and C2 are going to be nullified. The effect by C1 and C2, a noise is going to be added there. Okay, that is going to be reduced by using of the Wagner ground connection. This is what the theory it is given in the theory part. All the things are okay. This is about how a shielding and grounding of the bridge is going to be working. This will be asking for 5 to 6 marks, and sharing bridge it will be asking for 8 marks. The phasor diagram is very important. How it is taken, you have to write the current I1 and current I2, the V1 and voltage V2, and the total voltage V, V is equals to V1 plus V2. Then explain about each and every elements in the phasor diagram. This is about our dissipation factor is taken as omega R4C4. Then our loss angle is taken as tan delta is equals to omega R4 into C4. Then our power factor is taken as omega Rx into Cx. This is about our sharing bridge. From this we completed of the first module theory part. Okay, all the each and every the topics are very important for the examination point of view. Okay, next I will start with the problems. I will stop recording of theory parts only.